There are lots of ways that you can direct your viewer's attention. You can draw a box around something, you can use arrows, you can zoom in. However, one thing that can be useful from time to time is a spotlight effect like this. Now, there is a window spotlight, and there's also a round spotlight, and there's also a cursor spotlight. But if you want a square spotlight, you've got to do something interesting. And this is where the mask effect is very, very useful. This is, the mask effect was added back in Camtasia 2.2, and the longer I have it, the more I find reasons to use it and to do really interesting things with it. So today we're going to use it to create this rectangular spotlight effect. Now there's a couple stages we need to go into. First we create kind of this background or the kind of the shade. So I use a rectangular annotation and I just drag it to be the full screen. And I'll resize it to be kind of last however I want it to last. All right, that's good. Now what we're going to do is go to the video effects and add mask. And I'm going to want to mask this area, so I drag it kind of over that area. Open up the properties, because this is where we're really going to tweak it. And you want to make sure you're in the general tab. And make sure this mask section is displayed. Select rectangle, and then click invert. Resize it a little bit. All right, that's good. Now I'm going to change the blend. This is kind of the fading or the feathering of the edges. Just because I like that. Now we'll bring down the opacity or the transparency. There we go. Now if I click off, now this is the effect that I'll get. Great. I like that. Now I'll play it back. Okay, I don't like how it jumps in. I want it to fade in and out. I can do this a couple ways. I can add fade in and out transitions, or the mask has its own kind of what's called ease in and ease out. I'll have that go for a half second each, in and out. Now when I replay it, there we go. I like that. Excellent. So that was really easy. Another nice thing about doing it once is let's say if later, sometime down the road, I want to add it again. I just click on it in the timeline, Command-C to copy, make sure my playhead's where I want it, Command-V to paste, and then just drag and tweak on the canvas. Resize it however I want it to last, and there we go. Now we have another one right there. So one more tip before we end. Is you can also animate these masks. Let's say I want to start talking about this area, then I want to talk about this area for a little while, till about there. And about here is where I want to make the change. So I'm going to add a custom animation. Now we can go up to the Animations tab and add the blank animation or custom animation. And drag it down. I like to use the keyboard shortcut, which is Alt-A. Then just drag this over like that. And now when we play it back, you can see that adds the spotlight there, animates over there. So there's a quick tip on adding custom spotlight effects with the mask tool.